Well, hello there, everybody. It is me. It is me. It is Super D.
Super Dave.
And you guys are locked in to Milltown's Best. I'm cranking these videos out, guys. It is an amazing thing. Again, gotta thank you for sticking with me, watching all this content that I have been cranking out. You know, the watchdog is on the prowl, and that's what I am, guys. I am the watchdog of this so-called content creator, amongst other things. But we have a lot to discuss today, guys. I want to speak about two main things today. I want to talk about obsession. When is someone obsessed? I want to really dive into if this content creator is obsessed or not. And then I want to talk about this victim that the content creator has been speaking on lately that said that this victim supposedly had a gun pointed at him and his 8-year-old daughter. Well, guys, the internet sleuths have been going bonkers and doing their investigations. And I'm going to present to you the internet's findings about this guy. His name is Wes. That's all I'm going to say. I'm not going to admit where he's from. I'm not going to talk any details. But his name is Wes. And I can tell you guys that he is a fellow content creator, which makes my antennas go up, and it really makes me wonder what this guy's motives really were. And we all know that Mr. Cook has not been arrested, so there are no charges as of now, I believe. They would have been filed by now if they had credible evidence and they were not grasping at straws. This, of course, is my opinion. Everything said in Milltown's Best videos is my opinion. Unless stated otherwise, this should be taken as entertainment and me covering videos that I see on the internet. Public videos for public consumption. But guys, we got to talk about obsession. And obsession is really the key here. I have been watching the creator now for a while. And I was a fan of his at one point. Very, very reliable and dedicated fan until I started seeing more and more things I didn't like. And it seems like I am not the only person noticing how obsessed this content creator has become. The past several videos have been evil, evil, hate-filled videos that I honestly could not fully watch. I had to skip through them, to be honest with you. And it seems like a lot of viewers are feeling the same way. I went on these Facebook groups. You know, I go digging there for content because that is where you get the real viewers' real opinion that is not censored by the content creator. We all know if you post something that the content creator does not deem acceptable, he will hide you from the channel. He will delete your comments. And everything that you see in his comment section is praising him. If you want real, real, real criticism of this content creator, you have to go looking for these Facebook groups. Some are good, some are bad, and I found one that I kind of like. And it's not that it's all anti this content creator. Some of them are pro this content creator. And I hear you guys who say I need to come up with another nickname for the creator besides the creator. But I think that's the charm, is we know this man has a God complex. So calling him the creator is kind of tongue-in-cheek, I think. So the creator will delete your comments if he does not like them. So I go digging in these Facebook groups. And yeah, I'm milking these groups for content. I have no shame in saying that. But one of these comments really rang true to me, guys. And this is what I wanted to bring to you guys. Somebody said, anyone find it a bit weird that Jeremy says LP is obsessed with him, yet he is the one that has put out 8 YouTube videos in a row where all he does is obsess over her. He has even got his employee also uses references to Germ's neighbors in all of his videos. Anyone able to list just one video of LP obsessing over the Germ or anyone else? I'd say Germ has made 50 plus YouTube videos where his only topic is Miss Preston. Yet not one where she is seen obsessing over him. Very, very true. And if you guys look what I circled there, this post has 196 comments. That's probably 196 comments you didn't see on that YouTuber's videos because he censors. He's so pro freedom of speech, unless if you say something against him. I have been saying this now for well over a year, everybody. This is obsession. In my opinion, this man is essentially stalking. And in my opinion, he is encouraging his viewers to do the same. I would gather a guess. I would take a guess that if you were to go through this man's phone, 90% of the storage would be screenshots and stuff dealing with them, the neighbors. That is obsession. There's no family pictures, I'm sure. Not many. I bet you the percentage of family videos, family pictures, compared to his obsession is night and day. I'd be surprised if he's got 10 pictures of his family members in his phone compared to screenshots of this neighbor's alleged wrongdoing. So I found it fascinating, guys. 196 comments on that. And seems like everybody is agreeing here that this content creator is obsessed at this point. It is not, I gotta worry about my legal case. If your legal case was as locked up tight as you said it would, you would be telling your viewers, I don't need any more screenshots. I don't need any more evidence. We got this locked up. This case is sealed up tight. But you keep accepting this and accepting more dirt. And at what point? Is it for content? Are you farming content, creator? Or do you need more evidence because your case is frivolous? That's what I'm asking. Right? Like, it makes perfect sense, in my opinion, that there's something not right here. That you're obsessed or you have shit for a case. Right? Another comment goes on to say, how do any of you listen to this guy and not see that he is a con man, a charlatan, and talking about the very things he does himself? Open your eyes. And everybody, look at that comment number. 108 comments on that one post alone. And I assure you, almost all of those 108 are basically people saying, yeah, we woke up. We are not buying the shit he is selling anymore. And I'm happy for that. People are waking up, and it's putting a genuine smile on this fat guy's face, guys. Seriously, so happy. Here we go, guys. Another one that I found very compelling. And like I said, guys, go looking for these Facebook groups, but I urge you guys, be very careful when you post into these message boards, these Facebook groups. You can post anonymously. As you can see, a lot of these posts that I've pulled today are anonymous posts because we know how this content creator is. We know how these viewers are. They do background checks. On both sides, these viewers are doing background checks and all types of crazy shit. Doxing is really a problem in this content creators community. And they say it's investigating. And hey, I mean, whatever, just be careful where you broadcast that information, because in some states that could catch you a charge. That's all I'm saying. Another post here says, it surprises me how the diehard fans of this creator and harem members do mental gymnastics to come up with excuses for people. He often complains about people doing the same things that he does. I just don't understand how people can't think for themselves. Right? Makes perfect sense, doesn't it, guys? I think there are more and more people now that are thinking for themselves. And these groups where people can speak freely are truly a blessing. It just sucks that I had to go seeking validation on my criticism and validation on my opinions because this content creator is so butthurt and is so like so much like a dictator that he has to have only his narrative be the one out there. And it got to the point where this creator is trying to get, in my opinion, he's trying to get a law enforcement officer fired because this law enforcement officer, who's probably worked on thousands of cases, didn't see an interaction the way that he wanted him to perceive it. I think law enforcement officers who have been in the trenches day in and day out have a pretty good grasp on reality and what something looks like. And I believe the courts would tend to side with a law enforcement officer over a regular Joe Schmo with several lawsuits in the system already and a history of filing false reports and stuff like that. Not saying that this content creator files false reports or anything, but I'm just saying in general, I think the courts would side with a law enforcement officer over a regular Joe. As we move on, guys, we all know Jeremy McPhail's billions and billions suit. And it seems like that is so very true, guys. And one thing I got to talk about is we heard the story this past week of how these neighbors, these evil, dark neighbors... And we all know my opinions on these neighbors. I'm not a huge fan of these neighbors. I think they have their faults, just like this content creator. But I believe they are being wrongly thrust. I don't believe that they should be thrust into the public eye. I do not believe they are public figures by any means. I don't think having one 10-second video on a YouTube channel and running a nonprofit and having some Facebook pages makes you a public figure. I don't believe that this person is seeking fame or the public eye. I believe this person is seeking donations for a reptile rescue. I don't think this person wants their name in the spotlight as much as they want the name of their rescue in the public eye. So there's a big difference there in what a public figure is and what a public nonprofit is. And I think that this content creator is confusing the two, and he's thrusting these neighbors wrongly into the public eye and is forcing them to be the subject of public ridicule. And in this video, we've seen that people come from all over the United States to pick on these neighbors and see this new trash park attraction on this content creator's property. And this one guy said that the neighbors pulled a gun on him and his daughter, 8 years old. Police were called. Somehow this was the girlfriend of this content creator's problem. And she was forced to leave her counseling session to go on scene for some reason. Talk about inserting yourself in something. Talk about making yourself needed when you're not needed. This had nothing to do with the content creator, the content creator's girlfriend, or anything. But yet, she felt the urge to go on scene of a supposed crime and offer up nothing. She had no testimony. She did not witness anything. She was there to gather content. That's all it was. She was working for the content creator to go get some footage for a video that was monetized and still is monetized, I believe, as of this recording. But the internet sleuths have been doing some digging, guys. And it turns out that this guy who was made out to be a victim has a hell of a past. And this guy is seeking out celebrity. He wants to be a YouTuber. Go figure. This man has a YouTube channel with almost 3,000 subscribers. And that raises my content creator antennas, which makes me think this trip to Otter Creek was all orchestrated. And it was an attempt to boost views, to garner attention for the YouTube channel. But we see here from this posting, guys, well, all this praise for Mr. I'm not even going to say, from the flunkies, about how he has turned his life around. And we're talking now about this alleged victim. He filed bankruptcy, failed to make the required plan payments, and that case was closed this year. Why should he pay his bills? He can just refuse, increase the costs for the rest of us instead. Then he can make a little road trip to Florida to visit the junk pile of kids' games so he can so his list is currently forgery, identity theft, theft, robbery, drug dealing near a school, drug dealing to children. He's a gunfighter with a record of 0-2, and now a quote-unquote deadbeat. And you say, wow, how do these internet sleuths find this out? It's all there, guys. There's court records that shows he filed bankruptcy and couldn't even make the registered agreed-upon payment plans. We talked about how this man is essentially using his daughter for content, you know, family vlogging type deal. He's turning this incident, which he was so afraid of this weapon, but he's turning it into content. I'm not going to plug this man's channel, but he's got thousands of views and he is addressing everything. He's making content out of the haters, which, hey, more power to you, but at least be transparent and say, hey, man, you went to Otter Creek because you wanted to get in on this story. And I really wish you would clear this neighbor's name, because if he hasn't got arrested, clearly somebody's telling fibs. Who am I to say who's lying in this situation? But there was not enough to file charges, I guess. And clearly you're making views, you're monetized. And we can see right here by this screenshot, this thumbnail here, with your daughter, 8 years old, right front and center. Yet you have a problem with this neighbor supposedly using her adopted daughter. The hypocrisy is running wild. I couldn't believe it, guys. So as you can see, thousands of views talking about his past. And you say, what was his past? Well, this man tried to essentially rob a Walmart a pharmacy, I believe. So that everybody's calling him like a pill popper and stuff. I've had my past with drugs, so I'm not going to comment on people's pasts. I have a past. I got arrested once for stealing a donut. I was homeless and I was hungry, and I stole a donut, and I got caught, and it sucked. And, yeah, so, I mean, who am I to say this stuff? But my record isn't like this, guys. This guy's record goes on and on and on, and we're speaking on charges now. And let's just take a look at some of this man's charges. He's got theft of identity of another without consent. That's a very big crime, everybody. He's also has criminal mischief in the third degree, trafficking a controlled substance within 100 yards of a school, 1,000 yards of a school. He was selling a controlled substance to a minor. He was trafficking a controlled substance in the third degree. It was his first offense. He was also trafficking a substance in the third degree offense of a drug unspecified. And another charge of trafficking a controlled substance within 1,000 yards of a school. So it sounds like he got caught with a bunch of drugs in that case. Also, trafficking controlled substance within 1,000 yards of a school again. Sale to a minor again. These are separate charges. He got separate arrests. And another charge of trafficking a controlled substance in the third degree. He also has first degree of endangerment. Another charge of tampering with physical evidence. Robbery in the second degree. More charges for forgery in the first degree, check forgery, theft by unlawful taking or disposition, and theft of mail. This man's record is a mile long. And as you can see here, guys, we have a whole news write-up about how he had to got shot by the police after he tried robbing a Walmart. Very crazy story. And yes, this was in 2008. The man has a past. He says he's turned his life around, and I can only hope so. But clearly, In my opinion, he went to Otter Creek looking for content. We can tell that by the fact the man's got a YouTube channel and has followed up on all this drama with videos and putting his daughter front and center as if she's this big victim. Personally, if my daughter was a victim of something like that, I would have got her in counseling and would have said, this is not going on the internet. How dare this content creator try to put something so traumatic on the internet and milk it for content? But this supposedly reformed criminal didn't say that to the content creator. And we see not only the content creator milking this for content, the content creator's employees in their videos and all this stuff. Everybody's milking it for content, including this supposed reformed criminal. And I just thought you guys should all be aware that this man who is obsessed, the content creator who is so obsessed with his neighbors, she has no active charges for drugs and all this stuff. Yet you are featuring a victim in your video who's way worse than your content creator. And it just goes to show perspective and narrative. And shit is fucked up. Shit is skewed completely wrong, in my opinion. Which brings us to another anonymous comment here. Everybody has a past. Yes, but not everybody's past includes serving time in prison, robbing stores, endangering law enforcement officers to the point they have to shoot you, and selling illicit drugs to children. He inserted himself into a soap opera, making himself a public figure. If he didn't want that, he wouldn't be constantly on camera now. He doesn't get a free pass. Blank constantly makes claims about others supporting drug use, dealing conveniently with not a single charge ever against them. Just like I said, they've never had a charge against them, the neighbors. Yet he still goes on about how dangerous they are. Now he invites this guy onto his property, an actual convicted purveyor of illicit drugs to children, an actual convicted robber who had to be taken down by gunfire. Somehow that's perfectly fine in his twisted little world of that developmentally challenged germ lives in. Pathetic hypocrite and his flunkies cultists are the same. So true, guys. So true. That's why I like these forums, guys, these groups, because you're getting the real facts. I urge you guys to check them out. You'll get the facts on these forums, these Facebook groups. Sorry, guys, I'm an old soul. To me, these are like message boards. They're forums. And boy, is my hair crazy. Sorry for having it down today, guys. Lastly, guys, I found this chef's kiss right here, guys. And, we always heard that this content creator is very homophobic. And I can't say whether he is or whether he's not, but I can say there are videos of him using very anti-LGBTQ language on the internet. He has been known to use very, very derogatory terms towards homosexuals on film before. So this is what I found posted on these Facebook groups. The other day, Jay mentioned Landon, the neighbor's grandson, and proceeded to say, and his boy toy, Landon's friend. Explain to me why he would say a derogatory comment like that. Was he insinuating that Landon is gay? Just make it make sense. Why is Jay allowed to defame someone, but you can't defame him? Jay got mad at people for calling him germ. Isn't he accusing the neighbor of allegedly writing those posters, but he can call her grandson's friend his boy toy? Boy toy, a young person considered sexually attractive to men. Please make it make sense. As Jay says, once it's on the internet, it's there forever. Truer things have never been spoken, y'all. 20 comments on that as of right now. Guys, it's a crazy world we live in. And this content creator is adding to the chaos with what I would call obsession. And I don't think there is any other word for it besides obsession. You can see that he made a pivot back to content for a week. The numbers on his channel took a huge, huge dive. And since then, I called it out. And since I called out his massive loss in revenue and numbers, he pivoted back to what brings in the views. I wish he would just say, yes, I'm milking this neighbor for content because the drama is juicy and it brings in the revenue. And my CPM goes up when I cover the neighbor, because that seems to be the case, in my opinion. Guys, when are we going to see the end of this? I'm a watchdog at this point, and I'm going to continue watching as much as it hurts. As much as this guy really irks me and watching his content hurts my soul, I'm doing it for you. With all that being said, guys, check out these Facebook groups. They're a hoot, and you'll get the truth. Guys, I love you. Go tell somebody else you love them, and I'll talk to you later. Peace. Supa Dave, slicing through the haze, from the depths of drama to bright.